Welcome to Enox Engineering, I'm Alan. Today I'm making a radius grinding attachment for my Warden tool and cutter grinder. This is what it looks like. And these are the parts we're going to make. We have the table, which is half a circle, half of a 3-inch circle machined. We have the clamp that clamps the table. So this is machined on a mandrel. This is machined on the faceplate. So we see how we set that up. On this part, with the 1-inch radius on a 1-inch square bar, is machined in a forge or chuck, and we see how we set this up. The other parts, which are quite simple parts, just plates with holes drilled and tapped, nothing technical, I don't show how we make those. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. So what do you get in the kit? You get 3 sets of drawings and 2 sides of instructions. The kit also includes all the materials you need to make the project. I've set up my 4-jaw chuck with the jaws turned, so I've reversed the jaws on each one to grip this disc. This will be the table of the radius turning attachment. It says on the instructions to mark the centre, but as this is oval slightly, what I've done is use the dial indicator and the jaws and just get this jaw and this jaw the same, and this jaw and the opposite jaw same reading, so you know you're central in the 2 axes. And then we're ready to drill the hole. Just make sure your chuck jaws don't hit your saddle. I'm drilling a 9.5mm hole. I've set up my boring bar and I just want to bore this hole to 0.4 of an inch. Fourth out to come out. I'll leave it at that. You can see my little friends come for something to eat. When I'm in the workshop, if I have the door open, she always comes down, asks me for some food. Now I've just made a little mandrel with a 10mm thread on the end, just to hold the disc. And all I need to do now is true up the outside and put a chamfer on each side. The finished disc. I've removed the sharp corners. There's just a slight shoulder there that matches the diameter of the hole, and then I'll turn the face so that it's running true and the diameter's running true. Use my centre finder to draw a line through the centre. Now I'm going to saw this in half.
I've sawn it in half, set it up in the milling machine vise, and now I'm milling down to the line.
Okay, I'm just drilling some holes. What I did to get the position,
I used the edge finder on the vice face,
zeroed it,
allowing for the diameter of the edge finder. Then I used the edge finder on each end
of the circle, getting the same position in my y-axis, zeroing at this end, coming to this end, halved the diameter. That puts me on the centre, then just move out the distance of this hole. I'm using one of the countersinks that I had on my tool review, so let's see how this works. I've set it on slow. That will do. I've mounted the table guide on the faceplate. The table guide is some mild steel, 3/4 inch by 1/4, and I've drilled a 4.2mm hole through, which is there, and also I've machined it to length, which is 1 1/4, and rounded the edges off. So there's nothing technical there. This I found was the hardest thing to figure out how to locate it. So I fitted my faceplate. On this plate, there's no centre to it. It's just got a big hole in the centre. So I've clamped a piece of aluminium under the component, and that gives me the centre. And then with the centre drill, I've just marked the centre. Then using some dividers set to the size to get the centre hole roughly right. And then once I've got that right, I've used the dividers to give me the diameter of the cutout. One is for the edge that goes right down, just to give you a curve. The other is where the table sits. So then I just put the dividers in the middle, mark them out, so you've got the radiuses marked out. Now, a way of checking if your diameter's right is put some micrometer blue on the end edge of your disc. This is just a blue paste. And then when you fit the disc into the slot, rub it backwards and forwards. And if it's the right diameter, you can see there, the blue will show up all around. When it's too small, it's only touching the edges. As you get bigger, it starts to touch all the diameter, so that's okay for that. So all I need to do is check the depth, and I've finished on the faceplate. This is the finished table and the table guide, and those two just fit into each other. And you can see the marking blue on there, that it's touching all the way around. I'm just setting up my four-jaw chuck, holding a 1-inch square block of steel. And what I need to do is get this central so I can drill and ream a hole through the middle and face it off. The first thing I do is set my dial indicator up on the face, and then turn the bar till you get the lowest reading. Zero your dial indicator. Each division's a tenth of a thou. Pull the dial indicator out and turn it round so it's on the opposite face.
and get the lowest reading again. You can see there, 10th of a thou, so I'll call that 00. And you do that on the other two faces. And see on there, it's a couple of tenths up. On the other side, a couple of tenths down. So I can alter that by
adjusting the chuck jaws.
So on this side, the tenths down, turn it 180 degrees to the opposite side, 2 tenths down. So there's a tenth difference. So all you do is tighten one side up or adjust it to get 00 each side. And then same again on the other side, 00. So there's a tenth in it, tenth of a thou. So I'm happy with that. So I'll machine that as it is. And then I'll show you how to set it up when you need to set an offset.
First, I need to true the face up.
I'm reaming this 9mm, but it should be 11.32. Just countersink the bore. I need to cut a 1-inch radius on one of the faces. So that means if I just did it a 1-inch now, I'd get a 1-inch diameter, not a 1-inch radius. So that means I have to move the part 1/2 inch out to get the 1-inch radius. To do that, I'm going to zero my dial indicator. If you've got a digital readout, you can use your digital readout. Just zero the y-axis. If not, you can zero your graduations on your dial.
On your cross slide.
So now what I need to do is push that backwards in the chuck 1/2 inch. So to do that, I'll slacken the back chuck jaw off and tighten the front chuck jaw off up, which should push the part 1/2 inch. And to find out how far you've gone, just wind the top slide over till it comes to zero again. That has moved 0.2. So slacken it off again at the back, move it forward, come back to zero, roughly. 0.495, that's moved. So tighten it up a bit more. Move it back to zero. That is 0.4996. I'll leave it at that. Tighten the other jaw up. Tighten the back jaw up. Still reading 4996 on zero. So now when I turn the bar, it should machine on this side, then this side should be clear and the other two sides should be clear, so it should just machine on one side. Okay, I've changed my tool. Remember, this is offset, so one side will come round and hit the tool before the other side, that side. So if I just started to turn at that, I would have taken an eighth of an inch off that. Wind it out till it misses. And I've just got to go up to the parting off mark I made. Just carry on now until this has formed the 1 inch radius. One inch, it's just cleaned up. Okay, I've reset my parting off tool and now I'm parting it off at 1/2 inch long.
Left to saw this last bit off as the parting off tool is just about to hit the chuck. Now I'll hold it back in the chuck and face off.
I think that's finished except for drilling and tapping some holes. Now let's have a recap what we've made today. First, we made the table. That was done on the lathe and this part on the milling machine. Then on the faceplate, we made this part, the table fits into. Then I made this part, which I didn't show you. It's just basically milling and drilling, nothing complicated. That's a tool holder. And the same with this base. There's nothing technical there, it's quite straightforward. There's three holes, one tapped, two clearance, and two counterbores. Then on the four-jaw chuck, we made this part, which goes onto the end there. And that part's the feed nut housing. So that will fit on there. There's another part I have to make for this, where the table goes, and some other parts. But I'll finish that off next time.